travel, maybe 18 to 20 hours a day, back then mainly at night. Here in the center, we have our adult female, that's Kashifa. She's 4 years old, and to the left here on the rocks, we have her three cubs. They're all just a little over a year old now. To the left here, we have one of our dinosaurs live exhibits.
And the shoulder's doing as much as 600 pounds. And on the left is the Quetzalcoatlus.
And to the right here, next to the hill, we have our sloth bear. They have very long claws, which they use to tear open termite mounds in order to feed. And they're very excellent climbers and swimmers. Here we have our adult female. This is Dusty. She's 23 years old. And here on the left, dead center, we have a Bactrian camel. They have two humps, not the dromedary camel, which has only one hump. They can actually survive under the water for up to 3 months. When they do drink, they can drink about 30% of their body weight at one time. Down the right are the Nilgai. These are the largest species of Asia gigantism. It's 600 pounds. The males are known as Vuvuzelas, which is a gray-blue coat that develop as they mature. On the left here is our Dilophosaurus. Its name means two-crested lizard.
Hi.
Named the two around the early Jurassic era, and could reach speeds up to 30 miles an hour now. Here to the left, more than likely hiding out behind the hill, we have our dromedary camel, which is found once throughout Arabia, but now are extinct in the wild, and they're now common areas of the world in zoos and as a means of transportation. Here to the right, we have the sable antelopes. These are the third largest of African antelopes, found behind the elands and the greater kudus. They have the especially impressive appearance with their long herd horns. The glossy black coats of the males are a striking contrast to the rich, reddish brown coats of the females. And although they do closely resemble deer, antelopes are actually much closer relation to wild cattle, as they all fall under the family of Bovidae. Here on the right, we have our Pachycephalosaurus. Their names mean thick-headed lizard. And it's believed their skulls are as thick as 10 inches in certain spots. And like modern-day antelopes, they'd use these very hard heads in order to headbutt each other when they fought for control of territories and for mates. The spiky protrusions on their faces were believed to serve as atomic guards in order to protect themselves when they fought. And here to the left, taking a dip in the pool, we have our spotted hyena. These are the largest members of the hyena family. They live in extended social groups known as clans, which is around 30 to 40 individuals. Here we have our adult male, Scuzzy. I'm sorry, this is Dirt, who is 13 years old. And we also have a female named Scuzzy. She's 14. The Adax. This is a myriad species of antelope on the Sahara Dunes, searching for the scant vegetation which grows there. They can survive without drinking any water whatsoever, and can obtain all the moisture they need from the food that they eat. They also have a social hierarchy that is seemingly based on age, where the most senior members are typically in charge. We have the Indian gallants. The bulls weigh as much as 2,200 pounds and 6 feet tall, and the males are much darker and larger compared to the females. These are considered to be the largest of all the wild oxen, and they are easily distinguished from the hump-like creature over their shoulders and their white stockings. Here we have our adult male named Nundi and our female Kali. On the left, we have the Proto-Hadros. Its name means first Hadros, and is the first of the duck-billed dinosaurs. They were believed to be largely bipedal, though it's down on all fours when it decided to graze. On the right are the Arabian orcs. These are the smallest of the orcs, and they are especially adapted to desert regions of the Middle East. Their white coats reflect sunlight, while their dark lanes are heaved in the cold early mornings. On the right, we have the Acrocanthosaurus. Its name means high spine lizard. And it was believed to be an apex predator of the early Cretaceous period. It had powerful jaws, as well as strong forelimbs, which it used to restrain their prey when they attacked and fed. Here to the right, heading out in the tree, we have our Goin' and Spun-Nosed Monkey. Very white beards and a barbed wire mark in the nose to make the Goin' and Spun-Nosed to identify. And these small and curious monkeys use their excessive tails in order to communicate. They can also communicate by jerking their heads or positions, each of which means something different. To the left here, we have our Play World Playground, with a new Ship Voyage and Jungle Journey Playground, so 1.5 acres of play depending space. To the left, we have the Oasis Grove concession stand. There's a large concession stand here at the zoo, with the greatest variety of foods and beverages available. And here to the right, all the way in the back feeding, we can see one of our pygmy hippos. They are much smaller and different in appearance and more common relative than Alpha Hippopotamus, standing about 2.5 feet to 3 feet at the shoulders, and weighing up to 600 pounds. These animals are very territorial, thus we use this divided paddock. We have one male named Pogo, and one female named Kelsey. Also, did you know that hippos, they produce a pink fluid, which acts as a type of natural sunblock. Okay folks, now I'll be making a stop here at Africa Station. Nearby, we have the chimpanzees, lowland gorillas, as well as the giant elands.
Whew.
Side, we have our giant elands. They're the largest of the African antelopes, weighing up to 2,100 pounds. Despite their size, they're excellent jumpers, capable of jumping over 6 feet high. They can be distinguished from the more common eland, thanks to the large dewlap, which is a fold of skin under their neck. With the giraffes or other grand zebras, grand gazelles, and the ostriches. These animals can share paddocks as they would normally share territories in the wild because they do not compete for the same food source. We have our greater kudus. They're the rarest of the African antelopes in size, falling between the giant elands and the sable antelopes. The males have an especially impressive appearance thanks to their large open spiraled horns. Camera's now departing.
Oh,
left-hand side, we have our African black rhinoceros, which is in fact gray, and often just assumes the color of the mud in which it wallows. Once widespread throughout regions of Africa, black rhinos are now greatly endangered, though for their horns, due to the mistaken belief that they have medical value. We have another mixed paddock where you'll find guanacos and grias. Guanacos share an ancestor with the domesticated llama and alpaca and will bite, spit, and kick to gain control of their mates. Grias are relatives of the ostrich, and like their larger cousins, have very powerful legs that allow them to escape predators. Alrighty folks, we're now approaching our Tropical America station. Close to this station, you'll find our Mexican spider monkey, as well as our Amazon and Beyond exhibit. If you wish to exit here at this station, don't forget to gather all of your personal belongings and watch your head and your step as you exit. We have our giant land tortoises. All the tortoises we have here are from either the Galapagos or El Dabra Islands. The youngest is about 75 years old, and many scientists believe that giant land tortoises are the longest living animals, as they can live upwards of 150 years. Folks, we're now approaching our Australia station. Close to this station, you'll find our Sumatran tigers, the orangutans, and the siamangs. If you wish to exit here at this station, don't forget to gather all of your personal belongings and watch your head and your step as you exit.